Our Health Watch today. A new study provides evidence that brain scans can actually predict autism in babies prior to diagnosis as they get older. Many experts believe this development could make a huge difference when it comes to treatment. Dr. Kevin Campbell is with me now, first to explain what autism is. We've all heard it. Some people might not be familiar with exactly with what it is.
You know, autism spectrum disorder is a serious neurological developmental disorder that impairs a child's ability to communicate and interact with others. We kind of use this word spectrum in autism to better describe the wide range of symptoms and severity. You know, there's no cure for autism at this point, but intensive early treatment can make a huge difference in the lives of these children.
All right, tell us about this study. Where was it? How was it found? What did they find in it?
You know, one of the great benefits of living here in North Carolina, this study was done at UNC Chapel Hill. In this study, researchers performed MRI scans of the brains of infants who were at high risk for autism. These were the kids that had siblings with autism spectrum disorder. And what they found is there were some structural findings in these scans that helped them predict which children would later be diagnosed with autism. In fact, the scans allow researchers to identify 80% of those infants who would later develop autism at age 2 or older.
It is pretty extraordinary they can get to it that quickly. So why is early detection so important?
You know, first of all, identifying these brain changes early, there's a potential for us to develop therapies that could intervene in these kids sooner while the brain's still developing. An early diagnosis of autism is critical because the sooner it's recognized, the sooner families and doctors can start intervention strategies. They have lots of behavioral and communication therapies. Really help the child, you know, do better and achieve a better outcome. In fact, there was actually a study in 2014 that found is if intervention in autism begins as early as 6 months, these children's symptoms are far less severe, in some cases not even existent.
Pretty incredible for those families who are dealing with such a thing.
Absolutely,
no
absolutely.
Question. All right, thanks so much again for being with us again today.
Thank
for more
you.
On this, if you want to see this story again, just go to our website, WNCN.com, and you can also give us an idea of a medical story you'd like Dr. Campbell to talk about. Maggie?